So good afternoon to all our members who have joined in. Welcome to the next webinar by the Information Technology Initiatives Committee of the Bombay Chartered Accountants Society. Today we have put together a webinar on cloud solutions for Google and Microsoft. And we hope that this session is something that you can take away a lot of information from and be able to implement that in the day-to-day work that you're all doing. So we'll start off with our president at BCA, CA Suhas Bhai, speaking, giving more insights on the society and what it does, and then we'll move on to the session and to our speakers who are here for the session today. So over to you, Suhas Bhai. Yes,
thank you. Thank you both the conveners, Chairman Nitin Bhai Kinjal. Good afternoon, and I welcome all the participants. I could see around 200 plus participants here on YouTube. There may be more. So this is an excellent program by our Technology Initiative Committee of BCAS. This year, BCAS theme and annual plan revolves around transformation, and digital transformation is an important component of it. Transformation from database on server to database on clouds has become so relevant today and necessary today, with work from home becoming as a new normal. All of you must be experiencing it. Today we at BCAS, we are grappling with server issues and work from home becoming difficult without availability of a database, because our database is on server. If you could have done it on cloud, I think it would have been much more comfortable and work from home would have become much more effective. I'm sure the same must be the position for many MSME and small and medium sized practitioners and chartered accountants, and they must be severely affected. And before I close, I take this opportunity and I make a point to our chairman Nitin Bhai and conveners and the coordinators, that the service providers who are going to make a presentation today, if we can include them as our friends of BCAS, so that they can give us, BCAS and its members, a good package for transferring a database from the servers of our members to the clouds. And if we can enter into some kind of arrangement with them, it will be extremely useful to BCAS as well as its members. With these thoughts, I give the proceeding back to the coordinators. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Nitin Bhai. And we'll certainly see that we can make our speakers today friends at BCAS. I would now invite CA Nitin Bhai, who's the chairman of the committee, to share a few insights into today's webinar and his thoughts. Nitin Bhai, over to you.
Thank you, Ishank. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So, welcome, dear friends. As the saying goes, we live in interesting times. So, you know, these are times where we need to adapt to technology faster. Everybody has more or less adapted to work from home. At the same time, I think in order to make that working from home very robust, we need to understand how we can enable our entire operation into cloud. So our conveners and coordinators, that is Ishank, Namrata and Kinjal, came out with this topic and they've worked very hard on this. As you know, we are undertaking various webinars, whether it is Mr. Yazdi Tantra's sessions or other webinars. We are continuously coming with programs in BCS style to ensure that our members are equipped better with the technology. At the same time, we are open to all ideas and suggestions. So if you are willing to contribute, any particular topic or subject, because the whole technology landscape is so very vast, you're most welcome. So do reach out to any one of us. Our coordinates are there on the BCAS website. So with that, I welcome today's faculty. To Ishang to introduce the faculty of the day and start with the first session. Thank you.
And I'll introduce them. First is Mr. Junaid Kasmani. Mr. Junaid is a Google Sales Certified Professional, having 10 plus years of experience in the cloud industry and on Google Cloud. He possesses certificates of Google Cloud Certified and a Google Sales Professional. Our second speaker for the evening is Mr. Mohammed Ashraf Wadliwala. Mr. Ashraf is a GCP certified cloud associate with 5+ years of experience in cloud technologies such as Microsoft Azure, Office 365, and AWS. He possesses certifications which are the GCP Associate Cloud Engineer, the Professional Cloud Architect, and the Professional Collaboration Engineer. So with these two speakers, I would invite them to come on board and take the presentation ahead. Over to you, Junaid.
Hello everyone. Thank you, Kinchal, for introducing this. And first of all, I'd like to thank you, Mr. Kinchal Shah, for giving us the opportunity to present about your services. So before I start, I would just like to thank everyone for joining us and taking out your time to look at our cloud services. So I'll be presenting my screen so that I can give you some insight about the cloud solutions. So basically, cloud solutions, there are two platforms are there. Okay, so one platform where you move your email and file server on cloud, and there is another platform where you are moving your applications and databases on cloud. So I'll be taking care of, I'll be explaining, giving you some insights about the cloud emailing solutions and how you can manage your collaborations and work from home situations in G Suite and Office 365. And then I'll be handing over to Ashraf, who will walk you through about the cloud hosting part, how you can take your applications on cloud, how you can take your databases on cloud. So this is overall the session will be. I believe that my screen is visible to everyone and properly audible to everyone.
Yes, it is.
Okay, thank you. So before we start, I'll just give you some insights. Like Shivami Cloud Service Private Limited is one of the largest distributor in India for Google solutions, and we are also a tier one partner for Microsoft for Office 365 solution. So before we start, Shivami is a purpose driven company. So the purpose of Shivami is to bring positive change in the life of the people we connect by providing solution and services which bring profit and happiness. So this is just a glimpse of about our profile. So today it's like in the journey of 10 years, we have successfully deployed cloud solution in 10,000 plus enterprise customers. And in 2019, we were awarded as a partner of the year by Google across the globe. So we have a pan India presence and we have a proper team in place to take care of your entire transition of your office IT infrastructure on cloud. So we do have a Google and Microsoft team members who will be taking care of the entire transition. So this is a glimpse of our partnership. We are a partner with Google, Microsoft, Amazon, and there are many add-ons requirements are there by the customers. It is like Google solutions are available, and there is a need for some add-on services so that the customer requirements is fulfilled. So we have done partnership with all the add-on services which get seamlessly integrated with the cloud solutions. Like Freshwork has a ticketing system, leave management system, HRMS system. So these are the other requirements of the customers. So we can help that customer to bring all the solution on cloud, and we can make it very simple, like a single console to manage all your office applications from a single console. So the agenda is, as I said, I'll be giving you about the more insight about the G Suite and Office 365, and then Ashraf will be taking care of the cloud computing part. And in the last, we'll be covering the Q&A sessions where we are more happy to answer your questions. So I believe, you know, everyone is working from home, and these are the few challenges what we have identified. You know, people working from home, there are few can downtimes are there where it is affecting your user productivity, and people are not able to deliver your commitments on time. Then there is another challenge where everybody is conducting an online meetings, and people are finding it difficult because they do not have a proper solution in place, and they have to rely on some third-party applications, and still there is no a proper platform to conduct it seamlessly. Then usually people do have a file server in place where they are managing their document management. So again, when you're working from your personal devices from home, you are unable to access your data from which is there in your office laptop or desktop, or which is there in your file server, which is residing in your office premises. And the collaboration, in when we are in the office environment, it is very easy to collaborate with each other. It's easy for me to get into anyone's cabin, and I can discuss my plans, my planning, my sale forecasting. All my office work can be discussed in person, which we are finding a difficulty to collaborate together when you are sitting at a multiple locations and people are, you know, traveling here and there. And from the IT perspective, there are threats like now there are many office environments where the users have been given a limited access. They are not allowed to access certain content from their home premises. So now there is a situation where you don't have a choice. You have to give them an online access and allow them a VPN connections and let them access from wherever they want and from whichever device they can. But from an IT perspective, there is always a threat in their mind that the data may get leaked. And again, the storage is a concern. Then how do you control the devices? Since you are allowing people to access from their personal devices, again, the IT management team would be always be living in that fear, like what will happen if the user downloads their data in their mobile devices or on their personal laptops or devices. So overall, I believe these are the challenges, you know, people might be facing it. Apart from this, is there anything I would like all the participants to put your any inputs which you can give it, you can put it on the Q&A. So we can just cover up and we can help you out if there is any specific challenge other than this. So we can help you out how you can address that problem. So how cloud solutions can help you out. So now I would request all the participants to categorize themselves in scenario one and scenario two. Okay. Scenario one is like people are sitting in your office, and if any content has to be shared, they generally create a content in their, say, email or on their Microsoft Word, Excel. Then they try to share it by attaching that file on that email. Then possibly the recipients may ask you for some changes in that content. So you have to track all those changes. Then you have to consolidate all the versions, save it in that pen drive. And this is how you work. This is like a traditional way of, you know, working, which is going on. Generally, we have seen an environment where a lot of work which is going on, especially the CAs, their dependency is much on Microsoft Excel. They are much more into the documentation part. So for them, it is like they have to maintain so many versions just to make sure that all the versions are there in place. But tomorrow, any ambiguity is there, we can refer the old versions. So this is the one scenario where people are having these kind of environments, where your entire dependency is on the hardware. My all data is residing in my hardware. And by chance, my complete dependency on my file server, my laptops, my desktops, everything is there in my office premises. And there is another scenario where there are companies who have moved on cloud. Okay. And every data is residing on cloud. And for them, it is very easy to collaborate together. So again, I would request all the participants to just put your comments in the chat bar on the Q&A chat. Where do you fall? Scenario one or scenario two? So whoever is there falling in the scenario one, there is a solution for it. How you can move your entire infrastructure on cloud. Now, again, this is the second thought process on the scenarios where if you want to discuss anything, if you want to communicate with each other, either you might have WhatsApp groups or some third party applications where, again, which is from a security standpoint, there is a possibility where your data can get leaked. Okay. Or you are sitting in an office where you can discuss in person with each other. So this is the scenario one where people are working from office. They are collaborating with or communicating with each other via some third party applications like WhatsApp, Skype, or some other Instagram. It can be anything. Then there is another cloud scenario where there is a solution available to communicate with each other, which is called Hangout Chats, or we can call it as Microsoft Teams. Sorry. So overall, I would like to give you some insights about how cloud solution works. So here I'm just trying to show you about the G Suite, but we can relate this conversation with Microsoft Office 365 also. Both the solutions are the whole thought process and introducing the cloud solution. They are not anymore selling their solution as an emailing solution. There are the suite of applications which will help the company to streamline the entire process, to automate the entire process, and which in a way will help them to increase the user productivity. So there are many small challenges are there if you are using multiple applications. Okay, for example, in your current infrastructure, if you see for emailing, you might have subscribed for one services. For document management, you might have subscribed for some another services. For online meeting, you have subscribed for some another solution. So things are working. Okay, but through some multiple service providers via multiple applications, then the coordination, the integration, so there is a difficulty in that. So that is the reason Google and Microsoft came with a solution where there are suite of applications are there, which is the basic need of all the enterprise company. So it doesn't matter where these application requirements are needed only for an enterprise company, say 100 plus user company or 1,000 plus user company. It is not that way. It could be a one man company also. A one man company also will require all these applications. So I'll just give you some insight about how these applications are helpful for all the organization and how it does it fits in your basic niche. Now, the first part is about the communication part. Gmail. Now, either you take Gmail or you take Office 365 email. Okay. So every organization, you need an emailing solution as a corporate emailing solution. So this is a Gmail app. So these solutions can be seamlessly integrated with any of your email clients, say Outlook, any devices. All Outlook features are available on the web browser. You get a 99.9% uptime guarantee. You can create folders. You can create forwarding rules. You can have an offline access. Like the reason why people have choose, traditionally they were choosing the on-prem solutions because they always had a fear that what if the internet is not available? How do you access our emails? But now the situation has changed. Even if you switch to cloud solution, and in case if your internet is also not available, you do have an option to access your last 90 days data in the offline mode on the Chrome browser itself. Plus you have multiple devices available to get it synced. So your data is available on your mobile phone, your tablets. You can access your last say 3 years data also offline from their mobile devices. So whatever like if you compare any emailing solution in the market, it can be Rediff, Yahoo, or Exchange Server, or Lotus Notes, or say mDomain, SpearMail, Zimbra, whatever features they're offering you, you can just club everything. All those features are available. So you can come up with any of your questions, whether this feature is workable or not. It is there in Google and Microsoft. So this email application has been now had reached to that maturity level. Okay. And it is proven enough to, you know, provide all the features what all the companies are looking for. Now I'll give you one good example about this cloud solution. They have introduced called confidential mode. Today, if I want to share some sensitive content to my competitors or say some of the, if I'm submitting a quotations to my any of the recipients, so I can send it with a confidential mode. Like I can set a passcode on it. I can set an expiry rule on that. I can have an additional policy where these emails cannot be forward, download, print or copy. So I'm rest assured whatever content I'm sharing, I have a full control on that email. So that level of security has been embedded in the solutions. So just to brief, so from a security angle, you have inbuilt antivirus, inbuilt spam filtering, two-factor authentication, vacation responders, offline facility, mailbox delegation, multiple device access, easy to search content from your Gmail app. And as I believe, every participant, 99 participants are using Gmail at their personal mobile devices. So that is also very easy to adopt. Then for communication, we need a calendar. So calendar is again, what you're using right now on your Outlook, the similar functionality is available on cloud, where you can create calendars, multiple calendars, shared calendars. You can create an online meeting, you can schedule an online meeting. Again, this calendar are synced with your mobile devices, your laptop, your Outlook. So from whichever device you create an event, it automatically gets synced with all devices. Then to communicate with each other, we have a communication tool called Hangout Chat in Google and Microsoft Teams in Microsoft Office 365. So chatting will help you to create some chat rooms where you can a group of people can communicate together. They can share files, they can share their screens. Then we have Hangout Meet, which is for a video conferencing solution like Zoom. Now again, every organization is spending separately on the video conferencing solution. So it's like you are spending X amount on your email infrastructure. Then there are a lot of associated costs are there. Associated cost, I mean, one cost of video conferencing solution, one cost of additional email security, one cost of data storage. And there are other applications for integration, single sign-on. So there are a lot of associated costs are there. So we are trying to bundle all the solution under one console. So it will be easy to manage for the IT team as well. So Hangout Meet, again, Hangout Meets and Microsoft Teams, it's a video conferencing solution where 250 participants can join at a time. You can do a live streaming. You can share your screen. You can record your conference. All the functions are available. Then there is a concern of storing the data. So the traditional way to store the data is to have a file server in place, connect all your computer's folders into that file server, and all the user data is getting backed up over there. Let's replace that file server with online drive. So in Google, we have Google Drive. In Microsoft, we have OneDrive. So the concept is the same. It's just instead of file server, you are mapping your desktop folder with your online drive. So all your data is being stored over there. And plus the best advantage is like you have unlimited storage option also available. So if you have data, say it's an office container, say Word, Excel, photos, videos, some PDF files, which you're storing in your local server, let's put it on cloud so that people accessing from multiple devices or people accessing from other location, they have an easy access. Then in file server, there are companies who have created policies that users should not be allowed to download or share files outside my domain without the permission. Yes, you can do that. All controls in shared drive. So the shared drives and SharePoint, it's one and the same. So shared drive is a part of Google, SharePoint is a part of Microsoft. So we can create policies on that where all the content which is residing in my drive, online drive, I can create a policy on that, who is allowed to add content in that, who is allowed to download, who is allowed to share file outside my domain. All those policies, I can set an approval policies, I can define restriction on the sharing controls. So all those controls are available. Then searching of content. Okay, now you have uploaded so much of desktop data on cloud, you have so much of email data on cloud. Now searching become little difficult for a normal user. You know, he may not be able to recollect that file name or the content keywords, is not able to recollect what was the file name. So your cloud search is a solution for it, where you just put a any keyword, whatever you're able to recollect, Google Cloud Search will search your entire content from your mail, calendar, Hangout chat, your drive, and you'll get a filtered results. So your search becomes more easy. Then I jump into the collaboration part. As I said, people are sitting at multiple locations. And today it's a challenge for everybody to collaborate together. Like how you are managing right now, you are creating on reports, you are sending it to your HODs. They may ask you for some changes in that. That reports come back to you again. You redo that changes. Again, you send it back to him. So you can see how much time you're wasting in just getting an approval on a single document. So, because you don't have a solution in place for that. So you don't have a choice. So let's change the habits. Let's bring some change management in the IT system. How other companies are able to work, how the enterprise companies, those who have moved on cloud, either they have gone on Office 360 for Google, how they're able to complete that task on time, because they have a solution in place of collaborating together on online. So for collaboration together, in the traditional environment, your dependency is on the Microsoft Office, which is installed in the local system. And if you are not carrying that laptop along with you, you are not able to create any content. So there are the limitations. So we are breaking those barriers, and we are giving a user online collaboration tools where you have Word, you have Excel, you have presentations, you have forms, you have sites, you have Keep. This is an entire Office suite available on cloud, where people can create a content same like the way they were doing on their Office laptop. I can create a content. Then there is a collaboration functionality. The collaboration, I mean, I will show you one short video also in the next slide, how the collaboration works. Like I create a content on my, say for example, if I'm creating a content on my Excel file. Now I want all my team members to put their inputs on that. So it's very simple for me. I create a file online. I share it with my team members, allow them the rights, that view rights, edit rights, comment rights, or download rights, or a print rights. The entire rights are defined by me, which user will have what level of access. Then based on the access, they will be able to edit those files. If any user having an editing rights, they can edit simultaneously. It's like 100 people at a time can edit simultaneously together, and my work is done immediately. So I don't have to wait for an approval. Whichever is the approving authority, I can share that file to that person also. He can just come and view that file. If everything is okay, he can just put his comment in the comment section that the file is good to go and I got the approval. So I don't have to wait for sending an email. That email may take 2 minutes to deliver, or if there is some network issues, the email has not been delivered, or the same file has been downloaded into multiple systems. I don't have to wait for that. I'll just call him that this file has been shared with you. I'll put a message on the chat bar that a file has been shared. You can just check and confirm. So it's a fraction of seconds my work is done. So collaboration is very important component of going on cloud. So this is kind of a change management which you have to bring in your system. You have to change your mindset, because this pandemic situation, we don't know how long it's going to go. Okay. Other than this, now if you are planning for expansions in multi regions, so how as a individual you'll be able to bring in the traditional policies if you want to have an expansion pan India or across the globe.
So we have to bring a solution in our system where it is easy for us to have a complete view of content on the cloud. Then I understand that every participant must be thinking of that. If I give the user an access on the cloud, what is the security that my data would not get leaked? What is the security if the user may share the content to my competitors? I understand these kind of thoughts might be coming in your mind, but there is a solution for that as well. So now there is an admin console. Admin console will be under your control, and you can define policies for everything. Like you can think of a layman also, or you can think like you think of all possibility rooms from where there is a chance the data can get
leaked. I'm sorry, I'm interrupting you, but can you demonstrate this? I mean, rather than just speaking, share with the screenshots, how do they do that?
I'll be showing one short video about the collaboration.
You can be a little faster on this introductory part. I think everybody is aware of the Gmail part of it, the basics of Gmail. Okay.
So let's have a look on this. Let's have a look on this collaboration part. So this will give you some clarity. What I was talking about the online collaborations. So this is how it works. I believe it was audible to everyone about the music, the audio and the video.
Yeah, go ahead. At least video we were able to see. Yep.
So, Ishan, as you said, to a live account, okay, I can do that, but since we have a limited time, so that is the reason I'm just trying to convey whatever information, maximum information I can share, and anybody would like to have a live view about it, we can discuss with them offline. So I'm just moving on to the admin parts, like what are the controls are available. Okay, now the first questions comes in everybody's mind, what about the data security? Okay, so data security is like now in the cloud solutions, you don't have to think about buying some additional security to your data, like an email security or a document management security, because this solution do have built-in antivirus, built-in anti-spam, anti-phishing, anti-spoofing. There's a built-in SSL certificate is also enabled. So you don't have to worry about that. These giants, the Google and Microsoft, are taking care of the security. You just need to focus on your business. Then the second thoughts come about that if you're giving a user access of content on the cloud, what are the controls available on the sharing? Okay, so there are two ways to share the contents. One's via email and the other one is via online drive. or like a sharing of files online or creating some public links. So on email, I do have point to point controls. Like I can define a policies like whatever mails my users are sending and receiving, I should get a copy of that email as an original copy. So I'll be able to track my users, what mail he's sending outside my domain, to whom he's sending, who is being marked in the BCC section. So I can have a track of it. Second, I can set some approval policies on that. Like if these keywords are being found or this content is found, any user trying to share this content via email, it's need to take an approval from the reporting authority. So I can create that policies in that. Third, I can restrict some user. They are not allowed to share any content outside the domain, because I understand this. There are few users are there who are not allowed to send emails outside my domain because they do not have any work with the outside world. So why do I give them an option? Let control it. If they require, they need to take an approval. So any content which is going out via email, it is being controlled. Any content going via online drive, there also I can have a similar policies. There are a set of users who are not allowed to download data. There are a set of users who are not allowed to share files outside my domain. There are a set of users who are allowed to share files outside the domain, but to a whitelisted domains only. So I have that functions available in my console where I can whitelist and blacklist of keywords, email IDs, domain names. So as an admin, I just have to focus on the what policies I need to force it on my users. Rest, everything will be taken care by this cloud solution. Then we have an advanced DLP. DLP, we mean like, say, the data leakage prevention. So there is a possibility, like I can say that in your current emailing solution, all the participants are using some or the other solution. In their current solution, it allows only them to have some compliance kind of controls, like based on keywords, based on file size and file extension. These are all the only the limited controls available in all the other solution. Like any email containing these keywords or any email containing a file more than 10 MB or any email containing a Excel file or a video file should not be allowed to send outside. But this cloud solution has gone one step ahead. They are able to scan your photos. They are able to scan your PDF files. They are able to scan your data which is there on your drive. I can create a policies. I'll give you an example. Like now Paytm is a company. Now Paytm is having a lot of credit card information. Like the participants what we have today, you also are having a lot of customers IT related information, like income tax related information, which we understand that it is a sensitive content for sensitive content of all my customers, which I have to be reassured that this content should not be leaked by any chance. So in advanced DLP, I can create that rule. I have a blind template where I can identify some keywords. I can make a category wise blocking, like any bank account numbers, PAN numbers or credit card numbers are being found in any email, mail body, subject line, attachment, photos, Google Drive, the cloud solution will block it. So I don't have to mention the credit card numbers. Okay, this credit card number is found, it should block. No, I can also have a category wise blocking. So the system has an inbuilt AI and ML. It automatically read out the content, and if identify it is like a 14 digit credit card number, it will block it. It's a PAN card series, or it's a income tax number, or any other customized content which you want to block it. You can create a blank template and you can define a policies. So this is an advantage of putting everything on cloud and creating a policies on that. Then we have a mobile device management. So now if I'm allowing, now today in the work from home situation, I'm allowing the users to access content from their mobile devices. So the traditional way of IT infrastructure, you don't have any control, but in cloud solution, like gaming application are not allowed to download. You can define the login and logout time access. You can define the screen lock. Then, so if this is possible in the company provided devices. And there is a scenario where users are bringing in their own devices. In their personal devices also, you still have a control where you can create a work container in their mobile devices, and you will create a policy: no office content be allowed to make a copy or share from their work container to their private container. And whenever the user leaves the organization, you have a simple dashboard to remotely wipe the content from their mobile devices. So we have a proper MDM solution in place. Then there's an endpoint management solution for the laptops and desktops. Okay. I'll give you an example. Like in my cloud solutions, there are functionalities available where I can define this set of users are allowed to access my email and my drive from this specific IP, from this specific device. And within that device, he cannot insert his pen drive. He cannot use a Wi-Fi connection other than office Wi-Fi connection. He cannot use a camera. He cannot install any application on his laptop. And it will be like a single sign-on for his laptop login also. Point to point, it's like it's controlled by the your super administrator. So if you bring the solution in place, so you don't have to worry that if I'm allowing the users to access from their home premises, so your data is still residing in their office laptop only. He cannot take away the data. So there are only two rooms where a user can take away the data. One is via email. So you have created policies over there. One is via drive. There also you have created policies over there. What content they can share, there also policies you have created. Then whether they can download, do you have created a policy in the endpoint management where they are not allowed to download, where they are not connect any pen drive, they are not allowed to use camera, they are not allowed to use, for example, I can have a browser based policies also, like I'm allowing only Chrome browser to use it. So there will be only one Chrome browser, and what URLs they are allowed to open in that Chrome browser, like I am disabling all these, like a firewall setting. Aapne Facebook ban kar diya, private, sare private sites aapne ban kar diye. So wahan pe aapka productivity bhi manage hota hai. When the user will not get a choice okay, where I can, you know, divert my mind in socializing. So my laptop is having only my office content. I cannot download anything. I cannot take away from that. So this solution is also available. Then we have alert center. In alert center, I can define any kind of suspicious activity in the alert center. Like for example, a user trying to download a file, I will get an alert. A user trying to share a file to my competitor domain, he won't be able to do it, but at least you will come as a notification that these users are taking an attempt. So then I can start watching that user, why he is doing it. So there is an alert center. This is again a very powerful tool to keep a watch on all the users. Because see, practically it is very difficult to monitor each and every user. So these are the application will give you like a proactive support. So proactively they are sending out you notification that there is a user who is trying to break the policies. Then we have security health. In security health, like we do get notifications in terms of data security. There might be possibility where the IT team has not defined all the policies in a proper way. So this security help will tell you, see, these are the settings which are open for this set of users. You need to immediately disable that. There are various settings are there at the domain level also, like SPF record, DKIM record, DMARC records, which will help you to control any kind. Are being properly encrypted or not, whether my emails are being properly delivered or not, is there my any kind of spoofing attacks to any of my users, are any of my users being affected by any kind of spam mails. So this kind of a live picture, you can have a look at it. Then we have an investigation tool. Investigation tool is a very powerful tool in Google. which gives you a power to investigate any kind of activity on the user. Like as a layman, you can think of any thoughts come in any of the mind. Like how do we, like a thought coming in my mind, how many files are being shared outside my domain? Like I have given permission to some of my users that they are allowed to share files outside my domain. But there is a thought coming in my mind just to have a look how many files are being shared outside my domain. So in the investigation tool, I can select those conditions and I can have a live view of it. Okay, these are the files which are gone outside my domain. Then I can further investigate and further do an auditing on that. If I found anything suspicious, as an administrator, I can have a full control on that. I can revoke that access. I can remove that user. I can disable the download, print and copy function. So it's like you have a dashboard where you can immediately take an action. So this investigation tool will help you to investigate any activity of the user. So you think like a layman and any thoughts come in your mind just to investigate it. Okay, if you found that, you know, there is some data leakages happening. So you can just start investigating it. To think in a different way, like how many mails are gone to my competitor domains. So I put those conditions and I'll get a track of it. These are the mails which are gone out. Who has done it? When it was done? From which device it was sent? We'll get the entire audit logs. And there are built-in migration tools. So any participants looking for moving on cloud, so you don't have to worry about the transition process because there are built-in migration tools where it will migrate your existing content from your local devices, from your existing mail server to the cloud. So everything is, there is an automated process. So the only thing what you have to do it, you just need to provide us the information that this is the content which is residing over here. These are my users. I want to bring this user on cloud. So we have a proper team in place. They will be using these certified tools and the entire transition will be taken care by us. So just to give you a wrap up on this, so overall, what are the things you can replace when you're moving on cloud? So product, you could potentially replace it. Like currently you have Exchange Server, you have Microsoft Outlook.
Can I just come in?
Yeah.
So we're just wanting to move to the Q&A also. If you can quickly just conclude this slide.
Okay.
And then we'll have Puneet also join us. Yeah.
Okay. So
just conclude quickly.
Yes, this is the last slide. It's just to give them some idea what I was talking till now. Okay, like what other applications can be easily replaced with the cloud solution. So potentially for the participants are having either an Exchange Server or Outlook, they are using for emailing. This can be replaced with the cloud UI, which is called the G Suite. Then for creating the content, they are using Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, SharePoint. This can be replaced with the productivity tools, which is I explained to you about the online office. Then for video conferencing, conducting online meetings, participants might have subscribed for the WebEx licenses, GoToMeeting, Zoom licenses. Again, this can be also replaced with your Google Meet and Microsoft Teams. Then there are possibility that users are having a NAS box or a box solution or a Dropbox. They might have subscribed for the solution just to put all the data back up on this online drive. So if you move to a cloud solution, this will be also taken care of because we have all the application under one console. And about the data security, as I explained to you about all the controls are available, endpoint management, and plus we do have an archival options where there are security compliances are there where you need to have maintain another copy in some other servers so that like now all individuals are required to maintain their 8 years IT data. So I can create policies like I need to have a backup of all my data up to 10 years. So there should not be any deletion option from the archival account. So whenever any auditing is required, I can do my auditing from that application. So Ishank, I'm done. And we can just cover up the Q&A session.
Okay. Thanks, Junaid. Certainly all of this helps all of our members who have joined in. Again, in the interest of time, we're just going ahead with a lot of questions with which our members have put forth. So Namrata, if you can first introduce Puneet, who's also joining us, to help on the Q&A side, and then we'll take those questions from the members who've joined.
Thank you, Ishank. Welcome, Mr. Puneet Thakkar. Mr. Puneet has been active in internet industry since 1997 as an internet solution specialist. He has delivered many projects and established a huge list of clients. He's a Bachelor of Commerce from Mumbai University, but he has started his website development company and is now dealing in cloud products. I welcome Mr. Puneet with a big round of applause.
Thank you for the introduction. I am still not bachelor.
Okay. Sir, basically we have received multiple questions in our Q&A window and also on YouTube. And sir, we have also received a lot of requests from members to do a live demo session. So which should be comfortable to initiate first?
So question answer would be good, and then we can also have the live demo. Junit can take care of the live demo. Okay. As far as question answer is concerned, I think I'm seeing some 8-10 questions here, and I would like to address them one by one.
Okay, sir. So in that case, Ishank and I will read out questions alternatively, so it's easy for you and members to understand which point is going on.
Correct.
Okay. The first point is on pricing parameter. How much do Microsoft and Google charge per month for the cloud solution?
Yeah. So when we say cloud solution, what presentation Junaid has given you is from the office productivity or work remote work environment perspective. Now, here it is a fixed price kind of story. For Microsoft also and Google also, they go neck in neck. So Google is charging 125 rupees below 20 users and 210 above 20 users. Similarly, Microsoft has also similar plans, 105 to 300 rupees per user per month.
Okay. Another question is how to shift phone communication to cloud. Maybe use softwares like EPBX. So is there a way in which the phone communication can shift to cloud?
100% you should do that. Just for your knowledge, when I entered into the IT industry, I entered from the multimedia perspective. And today we are a cloud company. We are the sixth customer for a company called Nolarity Communication, which is also offering a service called Super Receptionist. Now, for almost 8 to 9 years, there is no EPBX dabba in my office. And every call which is coming to the office is recorded and forwarded to the user's mobile. And we are able to use the power of EPBX over the cloud. Okay. So, my audio is not very clear. Okay. Let me change my audio. Give me a moment.
Can you hear me clearly now?
Yeah,
better than earlier?
Yes.
Okay. So I was saying from the cloud PBX perspective that there are service providers who are providing cloud-based PBX services. Okay. One we use is Super Receptionist. But after that, there are so many who have come into the play. Variations in price. But motamoti, if you see, they are able to help you with your services. So most of the time, we want our customers to reach out to us and we want to record the audio of the customer along with a conversation with our representative. So I think that is taken care. Even outgoing calls are allowed from the cloud-based EPBX and you get a proper number, etc. And you are able to do it without any problem. They are reasonably cheap as well. So today what I know, per user, somewhere around 600 to 700 rupees for unlimited calling and receiving is a good, decent amount to pay for a cloud PBX.
Okay.
And it works very well. In my office, we are using it for almost 8 years now.
Okay.
Okay, sir. The next question is it better to use Google Suite than Office 365?
Okay. Very valid and very logical question. Both are equally good. If you are looking at winning the battle of tomorrow, then you should use the tools which are relevant today. Right. If you look at Microsoft, it came into the Office business 30 years ago, and they primarily dominated the market in that sense. But honestly speaking, they did not invent much. So Google came, and then we have a cloud-based Office solution, which in the time of pandemic we have utilized. But imagine a scenario, if you had no cloud-based Office solution, let's say in your Gmail you're using Google Sheet or Google Docs, and if there was a scenario of pandemic down the line, say 5 years, this would have not been possible. We would have lost our data, or we will be sitting at home doing nothing. So I would always say, if you want to win the battle of tomorrow, you have to have the tool which are relevant today. Always use the latest technology. I also tell my customers, my friends, that if in the technology business, the one who is late is latest.
Okay. So,
I hope I answered your question to your satisfaction.
Yeah, so just to conclude, in that case, since Google has entered late in this business, Google is having a latest technology compared to Microsoft.
Absolutely.
Is my conclusion clear? Okay,
absolutely.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Over to you, Ishan.
And I want to clarify here also. So you will have a question of interoperability. So suppose someone has sent you a document which is created in Microsoft Word or Microsoft Excel. Now you want to open the same onto the Google. I don't see a challenge. It works absolutely fine.
Okay. Just then a follow-up to that, Puneet. I started accountants. We use various accounting softwares, say for example, Tally, or have tax return filing softwares as well. Do any of these work on the cloud with a G Suite or Microsoft? That was one. And secondly, if I could just include one more here, whether any data that is there can be deleted, maybe say as simple as using a shift delete function, you know, we can secure data from getting deleted.
Okay. So there are two things we are talking about here. Let me clarify. The softwares which we are using on your computer are installed softwares, right? From there, if you delete a data, it is very easy to delete from an installed software, because everything is saved on your computer. But when you use on the cloud, it is almost impossible. It all depends on the policies what you have set. So suppose you say that this particular group of people are executive people, they cannot delete data, they cannot do any time. But if you say that some people are allowed to do that, they will be able to do that. That is the scenario with the cloud. With the desktop, you don't have any control as far as your data delete is concerned, right? Now you said that, do the softwares talk to the cloud-based system? Some of them are talking, some of them are not. Which one you are using, it depends on that. But I would always say, you could, suppose you have taken off Google, I love Google, I would say, suppose you have taken G Suite as a subscription. Okay. There is an option called drive file stream. You install it on your computer, sync it with your drive. Okay. And you put a formula, you put a security alert on top on the cloud that it can do real time syncing, but no one can delete the data.
Okay.
You still are able to save your data.
Okay.
And you get data both the places.
Got it. Okay. So I think what we can understand here, we will need to check our softwares and see whether they talk to the cloud. Right. So that is how some of our...
There is a protocol. You could tell your guy or check with them. There is a protocol SAML.
Okay.
if the protocol is open and they are able to support that, then absolutely they can sync the data from the cloud.
Okay. Namrata, you want to go ahead with a couple of more questions?
The next question is from Hiten. The question is, can you record meeting on Google Meet? If yes, please tell us how.
Very simple. You can record the meeting on Google Meet from the administrative control, and you can save it on your private YouTube channel as well. That demo might my team member will give you.
Okay, thank you, sir. We'll take it post Q&A demo section. Okay, over to you, Ishank.
Sir, another question. We commonly use digital signatures, Puneet, on a lot of our work. Nowadays, everything is being digitally signed. So that said, can digital signatures work with the cloud? And once that, you know, say a tax return is uploaded, then again, can a digital signature be affixed on a document on the cloud? This one's from Nirav.
Very logic and valid question. Let me just tell you, I entered into the cloud business from digital signature point. So it makes sense. Today in my company, since last 2 years, we are 100% digitally, we are sending 100% digitally signed invoices. Okay. We are able to sign documents. In fact, I am signing a lot of contracts internationally as well as with our customer using digital signature. Very simple, we can use it. Okay. It's just that the digital signature format, that is PKX, okay, has to be compatible with wherever you want to sign. All the most of the applications are able to give you that support if they are cloud-based.
Okay. Just to be specific, these are there are two types. One, some of these applications like DocuSign or an Aadhaar OTP-based signature. And then there are those which are these pen drive driven ones. So both of them, and more specifically the pen drive token ones, they work well on the cloud?
Yes.
Okay. They're the same. So we could affix.
Basically, when you are signing anything on the cloud, you are using browser.
Okay.
Correct. And that we have otherwise also been doing, because whatever we are selling online via the Tally or say even the software, we are using a standard protocol called XML. And XML has the capacity to use that. So there is no problem.
Okay.
So even the token one has a file which is called PFX file, which goes inside the token.
Okay. Namrata, you can have any questions from your side.
Yeah. I'll club next two questions. One is related to, is it possible to download data from Google Drive by a person with whom Drive link is shared? And second is, how are Google Docs, Sheet, and Slides compatible with Microsoft Office?
So I would say compatibility, which is called interoperability issues, they are sorted way back. So both are equally good. When you are using high-end macros in the Excel, right? The macros are requiring a lot of RAM from your computer. Okay. At that point of time, probably your cloud-based application will not be able to support you. But 95% of these files are not so macro heavy. So not a challenge.
Okay, sir.
As far as compatibility is concerned, both are equally supporting each other. Okay. Now the first question was data from the Google Cloud.
Yes.
You can always download your data from Google Cloud in the original format, whichever is kept there. And suppose you created a file which is on the Google Docs, so it doesn't have native applications extension. So the way Microsoft Office will give you DocX or XLX, whatever, Google doesn't store like that. It just stores the file's name, but you can always download the file in whatever format you want.
Okay,
you can
sir.
Download PDF, you can download XLS, you can download any other compatible application, the standard ones, no problem at all.
Okay. So suppose I am uploading my file on Google Drive. I'm sharing link of that drive with third person like Ishank. Can he download data without my permission?
Yes. So when you upload a file and you share a file, Google gives you an option to select what kind of sharing rights you want to give it to him. Suppose you say that you want to give all rights, then yes, he can do that. Suppose you want to give him a right to just view the content, he can just view, he cannot do anything else. Suppose you give him a right to comment only. So as a chartered accountant, this is sometimes very relevant that we give our client some file and say that you put a comment on it instead of sending the entire file. So they can only comment on it. They cannot do that. They cannot do anything else. Sometimes you don't want them to take a screenshot or, you know, print screen of the file. You can stop that as well. You can stop the printing option also.
Okay.
So Google gives you a lot of control.
Okay. One question, another one. So this is, I think a lot of us must be using it as well commonly. Is it advisable to connect our office server using RDP mode, which is a remote desktop mode? And whether, I mean, Microsoft has an RDP option. Does Google have something like an RDP?
Yeah. So basically, the very concept of RDP has come into the play because we have a desktop which is native application installed or somewhere. Okay. Google purely works on the browser. Okay. From browser, you can use RDP. But Google doesn't have RDP option because Google is natively a cloud company. So they do not create anything which is a non-cloud. But Microsoft created everything on the desktop level. So they have an option to use RDP. Now, when you use RDP, there are multiple RDPs like, go to my PC or say Microsoft native RDP. You need to make sure that your firewall is able to support that from the backend. If you are using a RDP without, say, proper firewall in place, proper firewall policies in place, that means you are keeping the door open. So whenever you use RDP, you make sure that RDP is coupled, okay, with VPN tunnel. And VPN tunnel also needs to be secured with SSL. Now, I would, if I was you, I would not even worry about it, honestly speaking, because I would first and foremost install a Google Drive file stream onto my server, sync all the data with my cloud, and whenever I need, I'll go to my cloud and access it. Alternatively, suppose I am working on very high-end project. In fact, I would give you a real-life example. I have a friend from Australia who's a chartered accountant who does processing in India, in Ahmedabad. Okay. Now, how he accesses his computer? So what he did, when the lockdown started, we worked on something called VDI, Virtual Desktop Environment. We created a server on the cloud for him, or with his softwares, etc. All the people from his office, from their computer, laptop, desktop, would log into another virtual desktop, which is provided by the company. So any data cannot be copied from the virtual desktop to real desktop. But you can still work on the cloud using a virtual desktop, and it works very smoothly for them.
Okay, sir. The next question is from Nirav Shah. The question is, in their office, they have one common office ID, and in that ID, they receive all emails from their client. The Outlook setup is done for that official email ID, and when they were working in office, everybody would access that email ID, download data, work on it, and again send to client from that ID. Now he's finding difficulty how to manage this scenario. So he's expecting your inputs on this.
Sure. So first question is, you're using Outlook and you're accessing the email multiple people were accessing the email onto one particular ID. That scenario is wrong altogether. Because you, whenever something goes wrong, you can't even catch who did this. So that's a wrong way of working, but there is a workaround. Now, when you go to Google, okay, Google has something called Google Groups. So you create an organization ID. Let's say in my company, I have a ID called support. Now, support@shivami.com, anyone sends an email, it's a group ID. And in the group, there are 35 people. Everyone gets the email. Now, the person who is relevant to that particular email will only reply to that particular question. Otherwise, everyone just gets to see the email. That is how I am working today. Now, in the group, there is a possibility that I can also receive all the emails onto the support and assign it to people. That, okay, this particular problem needs to be solved by this particular person. A will attend the, some problem. B will attend some problem likewise. So there are two possibilities where you could use it. Currently, you are stuck with your Outlook. Honestly speaking, get out of it. Go to the cloud and you are happy. Alternatively, have that same server replicated onto the cloud. With the VDI option, you are able to, with the virtual desktop option, you are able to do that. And then you work there. I hope I'm clear.
Yes, sir.
Namrata, sorry to interrupt in me. I believe we have also a pending session for cloud. So there are 3-4 slides are there. So it gives an idea about the cloud hosting. Then we can cover the continued Q&A. And if you want, then once Ashraf is done with the PPT, I can show the live account as well. I'm ready with your account.
Thanks, Junaid, for your inputs. But there are some critical questions and we have almost more than 50 questions. We would like to address that first. Okay. Post that, we would like to go for a live demo and then we can take balanced PPT section.
Namrata, I think if Ashraf has only few slides, let us get it in some few minutes.
I believe that Ashraf should be allowed because he talks about the cloud hosting of the Kali server, etc. And that is the need of the hour.
Great. Then let's go ahead and do it. Yes.
Have you given the sharing rights to Ashraf?
I'm just presenting it.
Okay.
Yeah, I've given him. Ashraf, you'll have to just unmute yourself.
Yeah. So, hello everyone. My name is Mohammed Ashraf. Today in the webinar we saw multiple times this cloud computing or cloud word has been hated to so many times. Okay.
Sorry to disturb you.
Yes, sir.
Don't get into the too much of understanding of what is cloud technology.
Mm-hmm.
Get into the solution mode. Okay. That is more important. Yeah.
Just a second, sir. So. Basically, if we do have any cloud, there are multiple questions like there are applications available like GST or Tally and other softwares. How do we access those particular applications? The Office applications, which are documents or PDF or Excel files, that can be handled by G Suite or Office 365. What about the other things? So if I say so, you are having an installed, you have installed your Tally on your particular local system. Okay. And now if I want to give that particular system on cloud and give 4 to 5 users the same server to use, you can use Tally similar way you are using a document to edit. Okay. So Junaid, can you go to the last slide where is VDI? Yeah, over here, you can see there are lots of servers available. Okay. and everyone want to use the same server. But there are lots of setup needs to be done. There are multiple system admins or there are multiple IT people require. But right away, all that have been taken care by the cloud. Okay, the all the systems, if I say so, for the server, VM images, Active Directory, connection broker, user data, it all been taken with a single username. Okay, I just go to my email address, my URL, put in my username and password. Over there, I can see my desktop. Okay, in a few minutes, we can show you the live demo as well. Where you can see all the applications which you need to install. For example, Microsoft Office, you install on Microsoft Office on your app, on your desktop. You can see a number of other applications such as Tally or SAP or Paint or Notepad. Those applications can you view, you can view in your browser itself. You don't have to worry about all the background, all the things which are taken place behind the scenes. You just need to just go to the browser, put in your username and password. Now the security, the VPN, the accessibility, the compatibility to others, all is working with simultaneously with each other. So if you are creating an Excel file on those virtual desktops, they can be work or they can be run on any of the systems. Okay, there is no need. There is nothing you have to process every time you create a file. For example, you want to work on Tally. Okay, you just go to your login and just put your username, start your Tally, select your company and start putting your entries. Okay, it's that simple. And it is not so complicated at all. It is complicated for the IT people, but the users, for the users, it just only in the front of there, there is only a username and password. Okay, so in few minutes, when we show the live demo, you can see this particular all system would be taken, we will take care of it.
Ashraf, I think the audio and video both is not playing. I mean, the video is just, not the
just
audio.
A second. Just a second.
No, still there's no audio. Mm-hmm. Can you come to that volume section, the volume bar, and play it to max? The volume bar just below the, yeah.
Everyone can see my screen?
Yeah, we can see your screen.
Okay. So this is my browser. I just use my username and password and I'm going to my virtual desktop. Here you can see all the applications which are installed on your particular systems. It is same way. I just go to the same way all other application which you needs to be installed, whatever the data you want to fetch, multiple hard drives, network drives, all that can be accessed via the similar way. Okay, so you don't have to worry about how the things will work. It will be taken care of by Google or Microsoft, whatever the platform you choose. But in the scenario or in front of you, there will be a desktop for you available always. I think so. I will. The tally license wouldn't be there.
So you mean the tally would also open within the browser?
Yeah, tally would be open within the browser. Whatever the data you have with your ERP, tally ERP, you can just copy it over here and you can start using it. Number of users, for example, there are 10 users who are using the same tally or the same tally data, can use it simultaneously. There is no issue at all. The same way you are using in your office currently with the LAN network, if I say so.
Okay.
Is there anything did you want to see in this particular desktop? I think so. I have already MS Office as well. Whatever the macros or you want to run, you can go ahead and do it.
Okay.
If somebody comes from the SAP background, we do have SAP integration as well. And apart from that, there are network drives available across many of the organizations. Okay. If you do want to use the network drives over the G Suite, you can use that. If you don't want to use, you want to go the old school, you can have that network drive mapped to this virtual desktop as well. So there is no issues at all. Everyone can see there are two taskbar, two start buttons everywhere. This is my desktop and this is the browser's one. So there is nothing in delay as such. Only the tally doesn't have the licenses. That's why it's taking so much time. Once the license is available, it will start in a jiffy. There is nothing as such as delay.
So this particular webinar, we had installed tally. Usually we don't work on tally.
Okay.
Is there anything else somebody want to see or somebody want to? Okay, there are participants who are raising questions.
Ashraf, a few of the questions that we received on the Q&A and also on YouTube are the content which was narrated by Junaid. If you could share live demo of those data points or those content, that will make it easy for participant to understand.
Okay. So as you see, there was a username and password available when I signed up. Okay. Junaid sir, are you going ahead with the demo?
Yes. For G Suite, I'll be taking care of it.
Okay. Should I stop my sharing?
Yes.
Okay.
I mean, also if you can enlighten the members on how do you set this virtual desktop?
Okay. Behind the scenes, as I said, there are multiple systems required, such as Active Directory, connection brokers, and the RDP technology handling servers. Okay, there are three main component or three main requirement for every VDI to work. Okay, Google offers them on GCP, Google Cloud Platform. Microsoft offers them on Microsoft Azure platform. Okay, both the platforms share you whatever systems or whatever infrastructure you want to create, you can create in a second. Okay, for example, there are currently in your office, you would be using a Core i3 machine or Core i5 machine with 8 GB or 16 GB of RAM. 10 of users will be using the RDP of the same server. Okay, on the cloud, we can have 10 or 12 cores of servers. Okay, 10, 12, 50, 60 cores of servers with unlimited amount of RAM. Okay, once, for example, any of your user who is available, who wants to do, for example, business analytics. Okay, he wants to run Tableau or Power BI, any other data analytics from the data. Okay, they can use the same virtual desktop. Okay, behind the scenes, it will automatically auto scale. It will automatically create that much of core or that much of RAM for that particular user. You have to make sure your IT administrator will make sure that this limit or this thing won't hit you. Okay, there are controls available to your IT people who will take care. But if you want that I want to run my analytics on 16 core for only 4 hours or 10 hours, you can do that. After that, you can bring back the 4 core or 8 core to the normal line or to the position where you started first. Okay. So as you see, there are servers available in your premises. There are lakhs and lakhs of servers available at Microsoft, Google, AWS, and all the cloud providers. You have to just go buy or rent it out, whatever the server you require. For example, you require 8 core, 16 GB. Just select it, start this machine, and you can have it. But for VDI, you require a technical person to configure all of this. Okay. Those things are, I will say, for example, there are bit technical or there are bit over the, theoretical, all the Active Directory, RDP and VDI questions. I just want to say that right now there are people who are asking, can we create a VPN connection? Can we create how can we create a secured environment for our users in this work from home situation? Okay. Right now, if somebody accesses this virtual desktop, it automatically updated to the latest patch. There is nothing or there is no incoming traffic or incoming request without being scanned. I can install, you can install any of the antiviruses you want. Okay. Automatically all the files which are coming in or which are going out, it automatically gets scanned over this machine only. Okay. So you don't have to worry about all those security, all those VPN and stuff. And you don't have to teach your users how to go live. Okay. There is a beautiful case study if you want to read it out. In 24 hours, VDI enabled people in Europe when the COVID started. 10,000 of users were started in 24 hours using this VDI. Okay, so there are many case study which have happened over the COVID times. So VDI is the solution right away if you don't want to get into the technical things and all.
Okay.
And apart from that, the cloud is nothing just related to a server only. If you want to host a web application, for example, you want to create a website like e-commerce, you want to create a website for a blog, you want to create a podcast, you want to host your video streaming websites, or you have collected lots and lots of articles and you want to paste it over the internet. You can use the cloud for anything you think of. If you want to create a converter kind of thing, you want Excel to PDF converter, you want to create it yourself, you can create it. There are people who think that online converters take your data, takes your confidential data. So you can just go to the cloud, go to GCP or Microsoft Office or Microsoft Azure, create your own server, put the code, and the things started working out.
Okay. So, apart from this, I mean, there are apprehension in many of these smaller offices. Mm-hmm. There are some applications which are not licensed version, but while they are in my LAN network, I feel more secured. But when I host it on cloud, what is the probability that, and to what extent do I need to fear about it?
Okay, so many of the users, or as Ishan said earlier, they are using multiple USB's token or USB digital signature. Okay, there are digital signature who works only on Windows 7 or Windows XP based off systems. Okay, which are very vulnerable to today's time. Okay, so first of all, you means if you want to get secure or if you want to get your data very means secure environment, or you want to share that confidential data with a confidence and trust, we strongly advise you go for the official licenses or genuine licenses of Windows. Okay. Apart from that, if you going for Microsoft Office or G Suite, those licenses will be taken care in your plans. Whatever the plans you choose for G Suite or Office 365, they will be taken care from that. You only have to acquire for Windows licenses. And second, if I say so, you require a good internet security endpoint, whether it is antivirus or internet security, you just go ahead. There are a lot of newses or a lot of articles coming on that ransomware has been activated or ransomware is in the everyone's email. So just take care whenever you reply or whenever you work on any of the unknown or unknown articles from the internet or unknown mails from anyone. On this VDI, you don't have to worry about those situations. If somebody is sending you a mail, or is somebody sending you a Gmail, or somebody is sending you an email on G Suite or Office 365, Microsoft and G Suite will take care of that thing. But on premise, until and unless you don't react or you don't act, there is nothing between you and that particular hacker.
Okay, so Namrata, we want to have Junaid some presentation. I mean, the live demo from Junaid, or you want to take up some question? Junaid, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, Namrata, shall we have his demo for 5 minutes?
Yes, yes, let's do it. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Can everyone see my screen?
Yeah, Junaid, we can see the screen.
So basically, this is the UI. I'm just walking you to the live account of G Suite. So basically, this UI, everyone is much more familiar with it because they're using Gmail at their personal level. Okay. So here I'm trying to show you that, you know, most of the participants are an Outlook user. So how you can manage when you're switching your UI. So instead of Outlook UI, you are using a Google UI. All these functions are available over here. Like I can have my inbox. This is the most powerful search bar where you can create your own folder rules, filter rules. Like any email coming from a specific user, it should go to a specific folder. So these kind of rules I can create. Then there's an inbuilt security available, that SSL is also enabled. Inbuilt antivirus, inbuilt spam filtering. So the security is taken care by Google. Then there's a confidential mode. Say if I'm sharing some confidential content, I can just send it, like I can put the recipient mobile number over here and I can send a unique passcode to it, so that if the end recipients want to open this email, they need to insert this passcode, or you can set an expiry on this email, that this email will get expired after 1 day or 1 week. And you can have an additional control on it, like the recipient won't have the option to forward, copy, print, or download his email. So this level of security functions are available. Rest, whatever the basic
any emailing solution offer you all kind of functions that is available. It's like signature adding, disclaimer notice, folder rules, forwarding rules, mail scheduler, mail reminders, then vacation responders, two-factor authentication. All those things are by default available. Then on the same screen, I have an advantage where I can, if I want to communicate with my team members, I have a simply chat bar available where I can, have some live chatting with him. I can create rooms over here as a create a room. I can create some bots. So everything is on my single screen. Then on the same screen, I have my calendar in place. Then I have keep. This is I can, if I want to kind of a reminders, I can put some notes over there. I can add a time on that so that it can be a reminder to me. There are certain tasks which need to be accomplished by today. So I can have my scheduler also. So this is the UI, which is very user friendly so that all your tasks are being accomplished in before time. Then these are all the applications which are available, which I've explained to you in my presentation. Like you got Drive, you get Online Office, you get Chat, Google Meet, then Vault. Vault is basically an archival solution. So all this application, and other than this, any web-based applications or your LDAP application, if you have integrated with your cloud solution, so you will getting a single sign-on for all the other applications also. Okay, so this is like a solutions where it is also easy for the IT person to provision and deprovision all the licenses other than G Suite. So I am defining a policy where I have defined a URL, I have defined the devices, like as a user from which device I can log in. I have defined the IP also, and the admin has defined the application. So this user will be allowed to use only these applications which are integrated with the solution. He is allowed to access this application from the authorized device only and authorized mobile devices and from this IP only. So that you are getting a full control on the devices. Plus, as I explained to you about the endpoint management, so if you are having a Windows 10 Pro environment, so you can have a control on the devices also. Like I cannot insert my pen drive or which Wi-Fi connection I can use. So these controls are there. Then I'll just give you an example about the collaboration. So now this is a Google Drive. Either I can manually upload all my desktop data on cloud, or I can have a drive syncing, which is, as Puneet has explained to you about the drive file stream. So I can install the drive on my desktop and I can have a syncing policy. It's like you get your drive for desktops, and I can have a syncing policy. So all my data I can get backed up into my online drive. Then if I'm creating an Excel file online, for example, this is an Excel sheet I have created over here. Can you see my screen? The Excel side?
Yeah, we can see your screen.
So now I have created one sheet for the Excel file on Google, which is called the spreadsheet. Now, if you can see the UI, 95% all the functionalities are available over here. I can see all the formulas. I can say sum, average, count, VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP. VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, data validations, pivot table, all those functions are available. So it's like this is the change which has to bring in by the top management, and you have to identify the user's Excel capabilities.
थोड़ा zoom in कर, थोड़ा file अपना तेरा UI छोटा कर.
Is it fine now?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Then I have an option where I can where I can send my files for an approval. So if my task is accomplished, so I can just pass it on to my reporting manager for an approval. So I just have to select approval and ask for insert the email ID, and it will go as an email for an approval. So the reporting authority can just have a look at that field and they can send it over here as an approval. Then now if I'm sharing this file, now we are talking about the collaboration part. So I'm just adding, say, Puneet sir over here. So I'm defining the rights, whether he's allowed to view, comment or edit the file. So here I'm giving the editing rights. I'm just sending it. it will show me that this is outside my domain because this is the test account. Now he will receive in this particular file on his email. That file will get saved into his drive. Now we both are sitting at a different location using different devices. Possibly he might open that file using his mobile devices, or he may go to his browser and open that file. Okay. Now you can see he is available online. So now I am just typing anything. See, so we are working together. So this is the advantage of collaboration. So every whatever it is there, we all can collaborate together. 100 people at a time can simultaneously work on this file. And it is easy to track also which user is working on which particular file, I mean which particular cell. Okay. Then I have an option. I can still download this file as an XLSX, open document, PDF. I can email as an attachment, as mentioned by Puneet about the interoperability issue. We can email this attachment as a Microsoft Excel or PDF. So it's just simple as that. Then whatever changes are happening, every chain has a revision. So,
and Namrata, we have just 3 minutes to conclude this meeting because there is another meeting which is there. So while we can take up one or two major areas of presentation, what we can do is the question answers, you can compile the questions, mail it to Puneet and his team. And whatever reply we can get, we can circulate to all the members.
I think that would be better for the question answers.
Correct. Yeah.
So I'll just give you 1 minute. Allow me 1 minute. I can just quickly. So this I have explained to you about the collaboration part. Then whatever content you are saving, that gets saved into your drive, which is your My Drive. And Share Drive is like a centralized repository you can create as an admin. So whatever content is created by the user, it automatically gets saved into your shared drive, and the department head becomes the owner. Then as an admin, now this is your dashboard. Okay, where if I can quickly give you about the DLP part. So here I can create all my rules, any email or drive file having some sensitive content, which is not permitted to share outside my domain. Here I'll be creating all my rules over here. Then about the investigation tool.
Junaid, there was one question whether this all these options are also available in the basic plan or these are some high-end plans.
So there are 3 plans are there. There are some add-ons are also available. So if the user want to go with if they have some budget concerns, they want to go with a basic plan. So
the DLP that you are demonstrating comes with the basic plan or the higher version?
A few functions are available in basic plan, few functions are available in enterprise.
So ideally, we recommend people to go for business and enterprise. For simple reason, business is unlimited storage and a lot of functionalities. Right. Enterprise from DLP and other things perspective.
Right. Okay.
So I think we should cover up the Q&A sessions because I can give all those links. We have everything documented by the Google as well with all the reference links and reference videos.
Would be great.
So we can share it. Yes. So we can just look into the Q&A session.
Ishank?
Sorry. Yes, Kinjal. Yeah, so I think I think we should conclude. We have another meeting lined up also for BCS. So thank you, Junaid, thank you, Puneet, and thank you, Ashraf, for joining in and sharing all of this with our members. At least we've got an insight into everything that Google and Microsoft have to offer. And as users, we will be able to make informed decisions on some of these applications and uses. Kinjal bhai, want to share anything to our participants and members?
Yes, all the participants, we will provide response on email. We already have your email IDs with us, and we will compile the list of questions and share it with you. We will also put it on the WhatsApp group as well. If you have become the member, so one request is that you please do become the members of the WhatsApp group. Namrata has been constantly sharing the link to join the WhatsApp group. On a very honorable task of proposing this vote of thanks to Puneet, Junaid, Ashraf, and their entire team of Shivani for their very insightful presentation and discussion on collaboration tools from Google and Microsoft. Puneet, BCS president, while you were not there, had already invited Shivani to partner with Bombay Chartered Accountant Society in their initiative, which is called Friends of BCS, which is like a partnership where members can avail various cloud hosting services from Google, Microsoft, third-party vendors, which could be powered by Shivani. So I propose a very well-deserved vote of thanks, a big thank to Puneet and his entire team of Shivani for sparing their valuable time and meticulously answering all the queries from the members. Puneet, once again, thank you and your entire team of Shivani. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate. And you are always welcome for any help you need in cloud computing. We are there to serve you and support you.
Yes, we have got a lot of members who are asking for your contact details. So while we circulate your question and answers, we will also circulate your contact details.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
We'll be there for 2 more minutes and take the copy of the question answers.
Yeah, we'll get that from the back end. Kinjal, while I'll be downloaded.
Okay, fine.
Okay, I'll end the meeting here. Right?
Yeah, okay. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Bye.